It's a good day for dreams. Concert. The rain's coming, so the flowers will be here tomorrow, I promise. Today is the AE Voices, our a cappella group, and they are all student-directed, self-directed, so they meet after school a couple days a week and work on their music. They get to pick their own stuff, and then they bring it to life right here on stage. So you just heard Don't Stop, which I'm sure you're familiar with. The next two are, we're going to turn down the bop a little bit. It's going to be a little slower. But I do want to make sure we recognize the soloists because their names were not in the program. Or did I put them in? I can't remember if I got them in time. In any case, we had in the first group, McKenna. Where are you, McKenna? There you are. Yes. And Austin and Isaac. Let's get out of the way. And then also Melanie. Where are you hiding over there? Good. This kind of feed in the audience, in a cappella group, we need that sort of energy. It's super great to have that kind of combination back and forth from the audience. That's awesome that you're supporting. The next two songs will feature a couple soloists too. Josh Parks, Kate Heller, and Risa Campbell. Campbell. Keep practicing. And then we've got a beatboxing thing happening over here. Chai, who does a lot of that stuff? Is The Night You Met, and then also that will be followed by Say Something, a Pentatonics arrangement. So I'll turn it over to them.
Thank you.
back to the night we met. And then I can tell myself what the hell I'm supposed to do. And then I can tell myself not to ride along with you. I had all the men, most of you, some and now none of you. Take me back to the night we met.
Say something.
Say something.
I'll be the one if you want me to.
Say something.
Say something.
Say something.
Say something.
Say something.
Say something. giving up on you. I'll be that one if you want me to. Say something, I'm giving up on you. I'll be that one if you want me to.
Hello and good evening. We're so glad that you can join us for an almost spring sing. It was raining today, so I think that bodes well for us. Our first song that Varsity Treble will sing tonight is called Sleep, My Little Sea, and we'll be singing it in Spanish. It was written for the music festival in Estonia in 2011. They have a huge music festival every year, and if you know anything about the story of Estonia, Latvia and Lithuania, people came together from these three countries to win their freedom, and it just attests to the amazing power of music to bring us together and unify us for a common good. So this song is about something so big and vast, like the sea, and this idea that we can rock it and cradle it and make it feel safe and secure. So here it is, Sleep, My Little Sea.
I am one. person can have, there is one that makes life seem desolate, empty, and sometimes not even worth living. When it is not there, hope. Hope for the future, hope to be loved, hope to be heard. When children are without hope, they are robbed of one of the most defining parts of their childhood. We must never underestimate the power of giving hope to a child.
I wish those who we have speak so softly. Are they really there if they hear them? My voice is so small and so soft. Can you hear me? Give us hope. I will show you the way.
Can you see? Look in my eyes. Can
You get to be filler because we're getting ready for something completely different, which is lovely, right? We love a nice, like, variety of songs, and unfortunately don't get a nice variety of jokes. I only know one, and it's a knock-knock joke, so would you help me out? Knock-knock?
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana.
Knock-knock?
Who's there?
Banana. Knock, knock. Banana. Knock, knock. Banana. Knock, knock. Orange. Orange, you went, I didn't see a banana? All right, here comes. Trolls.
Very high up.
Thank you very much. That first song was a song sung in Swahili that basically celebrated loving to sing and move. So that is what we do here. We're going to switch gears a lot and slow it down a bit with a sea shanty. Sea shanties were traditionally used to sort of pass time on long sea journeys. Sometimes it was to help coordinate movement between like heavy labor as people were working together. But really it was just sort of to make sure that you had something to do while you were doing stuff that was really tough. So this one is one that's a little bit more on a subtle side, a sadder side. But there are many arrangements of this, but our version is by Daniel Lynch. This is Leave Her Johnny. Thank you. composer Tim Takash has this to say about the next piece. This song is a text about setting the bar high and missing it. It's a chance for male singers to be vulnerable and honest. Everyone has had that experience where they don't make the team. Their name is not on the callback list. The test comes back with a C minus on it, or a D, or an F. She says no, he says no. How does that feel? It feels like a bone in the desert, bleached, dry, needing water. It feels like a swinging gate, neither closed nor open, hovering somewhere in between. It feels like a bell, calling for someone who never comes. This is Empty by Tim Takash.
The young men in front of you here in this small group participated in solo and ensemble festival a few weekends ago. And for those who don't know, it's a chance for small groups or solos to perform in front of a judge and get some feedback and learn from the experience. This group performed very well, and they have the opportunity next to go and perform at the state event. So they earned that honor. Yes, you can get great. They told me not to tell you that, because now we've set the expectation bar really high. So now they have nothing else to do but live up to that moment. So this is Black is the Color of My True Love's Hair.
I know my
Time, even farther than Earth Angel, to a song that words were written over 2,700 years ago. And so the words are actually in Sanskrit. And if there's anybody here who actually understands Sanskrit, great. But I don't think anybody will. So if I'm saying it wrong, no one will know. But we've worked hard at saying a few words in Sanskrit. The words themselves have a kind of chant-like feel to them, and the composer wanted to take these words from 2,700 years ago and sort of contemporarize them a bit. And to do so, he's also using a very unique style of composition that really has some clashy sounds together. So we're going to preview your ear, get your ears used to this real quick. So the sounds are, this is really nerdy of me, but music is written in steps, like, you know, do, re, mi, sing with me, you can do this. Do, ready, go. Do, re, mi. Look, you did it. Do it again, because you're so good. Do, re, mi. Now, that's called a major scale, the start of it. But there are notes that live between the notes. Everyone say, oh, boy! Oh. And the notes between the notes are called half steps, and they create this kind of crunchy sound like this. Jaws, for anybody who doesn't know. And those two notes together, when you play them at the same time, it creates this beautiful sound. It sounds like someone learning to play the piano, or a cat walking across the keyboard. This is intentional in this song, that there's this clash. So we're going to just preview a little bit of it from your ears. Can you sing me a nice solid and keep going for a long time? Ready and go. So they're going to sing that note, I'm going to sing a note right next to it. I'm going to sing not this note, but I'm going to sing. That clashing sound is what this composer leaned into, because it was a tradition in this chant style from 2,700 years ago. We don't know how it actually sounded because, you know, tape recorders and stuff didn't exist. Tape recorders don't even exist now. What am I talking about? But this song wants to call back to that time period. So it's different. It's contemporary and it's old. It's a mesh together. This is Gamaya.
Come on. because you've got a lot more to say. And we'll claim blame later.
The next two songs sort of, well, actually, the next three sort of tell a little story. Here at East this month, we have a theme that we're talking about called Words Matter. And it's been a evolution over time, but essentially it comes down to the fact that the words we use to address other people, to build relationships, they matter. And sometimes they can hurt, and sometimes they can help, and we should be conscious of those choices. And this first song, Does the World Say, talks about the way we receive messages from the world around us. And this is especially pertinent, I think, in the high school setting in relations to relationships, social media, advertisements, the way that our young people receive messages from the world and how we deal with that. And this message, or the song, sends a message that it's through our friendships that we can build back the courage to continue going. So leaning into those positive relationships. So Does the World Say leads us into the song You Say, which talks about how we get influences from other people as well. So there's a pair there. And then we're gonna pick it up at the end and sort of try to switch gears and say, you know what? Sometimes we just have to believe in what we believe and not be afraid of our own dreams and to chase them. So these next three songs are sort of a set. I ask that you hold your applause in the songs until the end to acknowledge soloists. So just as a reminder. So thank you. This is Does the World Say.
Thank you. We have to give a big round for Sarah Wheeler for two reasons. One, she's going to try to escape, and this is her last song she plays on. And two, before the concert, she came up and said, "Mr. Wheeler, my name isn't in the program. Does that mean I don't have to play?" And I said, "No! I'm so sorry." So let's give a big round of applause for Sarah Wheeler. The next song slows it down once more, and there are a number of moments in the song where it feels like it could pause and end, and you might be tempted to clap for us. Don't. I mean, at the end, fine. But wait for that moment. We really enjoy those musical moments of silence, because so much of that actually helps inform what comes next. We'll let the text speak for itself. This is "Sing Me to Heaven."
If you would win my heart,
going to end with a party. You're all invited. You won't understand any of our words. But it doesn't matter because this is universal, the spirit of celebration. This music is written in a foreign language, comes from a language called Resian, which is, again, it's not Sanskrit, but I bet no one here understands it. But what this is a party song from a wedding. It's essentially the wedding party is so out of control that their feet are stomping so loudly and their dancing is so boisterous that it echoes off the giant mountains and drowns out the sound of the river. Big party, huh? Yeah. So we're gonna party up here and you're gonna smile, hopefully, and maybe at the end you'll applaud for us. When we stomp and clap, you don't have to stomp and clap with us. We work really hard on ours. And there's some really fun stuff. I hope you enjoy it. This is our finale. We thank you for being here. And I wanna also thank, besides Sarah, who's helped out a lot, Heidi in the booth, Christina Kahn, who's around here somewhere, deserves a lot of appreciation. And also, I wanna thank you for being here, parents, family members, everyone, for coming out and supporting, once again, music education and the power of this process to create the world a better place, to make this just a better world for us all. Music can do that, and I firmly believe it. So thank you, thank the students. This is Tana Solbitsi.
It's a part.
And it's a little bit right.
Yo le lo li li lo, yo lo le lo li li lo, yo lo le lo li li lo, yo lo le lo li li lo.
Tana sobiti, se poraccio leo, yelo li li le li le li lo, yo le li lo. Tana sobiti, se poraccio leo, si yelo li li le lo, le le li lo, yo le li lo. Son nuge, nagas nuge terma leo, so pilo.
Fantastic evening and a wonderful St. Patrick's Day tomorrow. All right.
I'm